Hello, welcome to my channel. It is very easy to prepare your tax return. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use TurboTax online to prepare your tax return. There are many CRA certified software. Some are free, some are not. You can choose the one that best meets your needs. I always start by reviewing my notice of assessment from the prior year to see if I have any carry forward amount. For example, LRSP contribution limit and just the tuition amount. In addition to T3, T4, T5, you may also have receipt for medical expenses, donations, home office expenses, etc. It is very important to keep all of your supporting documents for at least 6 years.
Last year, I only made videos on UFile and Wealthsimple Tax, and some viewers asked me to make a video on TurboTax, so I'm doing a tutorial on TurboTax this year. The first step is to log into TurboTax online. If you don't have an account, you have to create a new account. After you log into TurboTax, you can start a new 2024 return. Click Let's Go. Select all the items that are relevant for you. Click Continue. Choose the option that you prefer. Based on what you selected in the previous steps, it will recommend the product for you. It will also indicate the pricing information. There are many CRA certified software. Some are free, some are not, and you can choose the one that best meets your needs. If you would like to proceed using TurboTax, you can click Start for free. Then answer some background information. There are benefits for preparing your tax return and your spouse or common law partner's tax return together, because it would be easier for the software to optimize the deductions and tax credits. At the end, the software will generate two tax returns, and you have to file those separately. Indicate your marital status and whether your status has changed in 2024, and click Continue. Enter your province or territory of residence on December 31st, 2024. It is important to recognize that residency status for income tax purposes is not the same as residency status for immigration purposes. If you become a resident of Canada for income tax purposes in 2024, you need to enter your date of entry and your income earned while you were a non-resident. The income earned as a non-resident before moving to Canada is non-taxable, except for income you received it from Canadian source. Income earned as a non-resident is required to calculate certain benefits and credits. If you are not sure about your residency status for income tax purposes, you should contact the CRA or consult with a professional. If you moved it in 2024 from one province or territory to another, you have to put in the date of your move. Confirm whether you are a Canadian citizen. Do you need to file your tax return for any prior year? I'm going to choose no. If you intend to file your prior year's return, please file your returns in order, meaning the oldest return first. This is because any prior year amount could potentially impact your current year amount. Put in your mailing address. Confirm whether your home address is the same as your mailing address. Put in your telephone number. Specify your preferred language. Click Continue. Do you have any dependents? Enter your date of birth and social insurance number. Review your information to ensure it is entered correctly. Click Continue. Click Start to start your tax profile. Check all the boxes that are relevant for you. Click Continue. Answer some mandatory CRA questions. Are you filing the tax return for the very first time? Did you own any specified foreign property in 2024 with a total cost over $100,000? If your answer to this question is yes, or you are not sure, you should consult with a professional. This is because the rules for foreign property T1135 reporting are very complex. Answer all the questions on this page. The software will recommend the next step. You can click Start to add the information as per your tax slip. Alternatively, you can search for a form or topic in the search box. To make this demo more efficient, I already entered all the information. For the T4 employment income, you need to enter all the information as per your T4 tax slip given to you by your employer. Once you are done entering all the information in the corresponding boxes, double-check the information to make sure that you entered everything correctly. Then you can click Save and Continue. If you have more than one T4, you can click Save and add another T4 to enter the information from your other T4 tax slip. For T5 investment income, for this example, I'm going to assume I earned interest income. Interest income is reported in box 13. Once you are done entering all the information based on your tax slip, click Done with T5 or Enter New T5. I worked from home in 2024, and I met the CRA criteria for using the detailed method to claim home office expenses. We'll go to the employment expenses section. Choose the option that is relevant for you. Remember, you need supporting documents and a signed T2200 from your employer in order to use the detailed method. Check all the boxes that are relevant for you. To calculate the percentage of your home being used for employment purposes, use a reasonable basis. Once you have entered all the relevant information, click Continue. We'll look at LLSP. For the LLSP, you have to enter your deduction limit for 2024. You can find this information on your 2023 Notice of Assessment. Enter your deduction limit and contributions. You can choose whether to use all of your LLSP deduction in the current year, or save all or some to future years. Next, we'll look at donations. Enter the organization name and the donation amount. The software will provide recommendations on how to maximize the tax credit. For the medical expenses, I purchased a pair of glasses for $500. If you have more than one medical expense, you can click Enter New Medical Expense and enter the information from all of your receipts. For medical expenses, to qualify for the tax credit, your medical expenses must be more than the lesser of 3% of your 2024 net income, or $2,759. If you are not sure, you can enter all of your expenses into the software. The software will determine whether you are eligible for the medical expense tax credit. Next, we'll look at tuition. Enter the information based on your T2202. You can find your unused tuition amount from prior years on your previous year's Notice of Assessment and in your CLA My Account. For the purpose of the Canada carbon rebate, we have to specify the area that we live in. If you have a spouse or common law partner and you would like to prepare your tax returns together, you can add their information based on their tax slips. The questions are basically the same. Once you are done entering all the information, you can review your return. The software calculates the refund or balance owing. It will also identify if there are any errors or tax savings opportunities. When you are ready to file your tax return, you can go to the Finish and File session. After you file your tax return, you'll get a confirmation number for each tax return. Please keep this for your record. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my video, please subscribe, like, and share. See you next time.